don't drag your foot, boy. Look what we got here. Hey, you want to drive, huh? Come on. See that telephone pole? We'll take you to it. Yeah, we can take you. Yeah, come on. You want to try?
Sure.
Rev it up. Come on, man. Get ready.
Thank you. supervise the installation myself. The accident won't delay your going, will it?
No. I'm leaving this morning. There's nothing I can do here.
That's right. Well, Mary, you'll make a fine organist for that church. Be very satisfying to you, I think.
It's just a job.
Well, it's not quite the attitude for going into church work.
I'm not taking the vows. I'm only going to play the organ.
Want more than that? Of course, it doesn't pay much, but, well, at least it's a start. Are you driving by Benton to see your folks?
No, I can't. I must hurry. I've got to leave. I'm going to drive straight through.
Mary, it takes more than intellect to be a musician. Put your soul into it a little. Okay? Good luck, Mary. Stop by and see us the next time you're in.
Thank you. But I'm never coming back.
Something like humbleness or gratitude.
Never know what she thinks. She's always kept pretty much to herself.
Yeah, maybe in her place I'd do the same thing. Just pick up life again.
Well, she's so quiet like, she fools you. But she's a tough-minded little thing.
I guess that's what it takes to survive. I'd still say she's behaving strange.
Well, if she's got a problem, it'll go right along with her.
Yep.
Lake used to be a pretty risky place in the old days. Then the lake went down and they made a dance hall out of it. Then they put those buildings up out there and made some sort of a carnival there for a while. That's years ago, though. Just stands out there now.
I see. I have an address here of a rooming house. Could you direct me?
Oh, sure. Well, that fits right over here, little way.
Been saving it for you since I got your letter. I could have rented it yesterday if I wanted. Oh, you're just fine. Just about what I expected. I knew you'd like. There's ain't no regular rooming house, you know. I only got you, Mr. Linden, across the hall. This room's got its own private bathroom, too. You can take all the baths you want. I'm not one to fuss about things like that. Thank you. I think I'll be quite comfortable. Well, hope you'll stay a while. I'm downstairs in the back part of the house, so if there's anything else you need, guess you'll have to wait in the morning. Good night. Good night, Mr. Talbot.
Isolation from the human race.
Mind if I try this now?
I want you to.
Thank you.
nothing at all. I practiced all afternoon and got me in the mood.
You need some fresh air. I've got to make a call out past the lake. Would you like to come along for the ride?
You know that old pavilion out there?
Mm-hmm.
Will we pass it?
Go right by it. Stop and look at it if you like.
I would, with you along.
Good. This used to be quite a place. It's been deserted for a long time now.
Will you take me in?
My goodness, no. It isn't safe out there anymore. That's why they put up this barrier.
It'd be very easy to step around it.
What attraction could there be for you out there?
I'm not sure. I'm a reasonable person. I don't know. Maybe I want to satisfy myself that the place is nothing more than it appears to be. Would you take me out there?
No. The law has placed it off limits. Wouldn't be very seemly for a minister to break the law, would it?
No. Maybe I can come back some other time.
Shall we go along now?
For a long drive in the country with my new boss. The elderly women. The old school. That must have been a trick of my head. Coming back from my other boarding is delicious. You got some chocolate? Oh, cigar. Well, it ain't a boarding house, but I got some coffee and a sandwich making left. I could bring it to my mom after a while. Sure. I'll be taking one of those bags you're so generous with. Or take as many as you want. I ain't going to make a fuss about a thing like that.
And I'm your neighbor right across the hall.
Nice to meet you. Did you see it?
Hey, yeah, yeah. I was wondering if you're not doing it.
Stand right there.
Being neighborly and all this. I haven't eaten anything either.
I thought he had asked you out for dinner.
That's very thoughtful of you, but I can't accept.
I haven't met or anything yet, but I just thought
I'm sorry,
you
have to excuse me.
Look, there's a Wushamite restaurant right down the street. I just thought, what kind of guy doesn't like to be by himself?
I've made arrangements to keep my room for now.
Let's go.
Good night, Mr. Lane.
Worse than my knees.
I didn't hear him, Mrs. Thompson. I saw him. Now, don't talk that way. I don't sleep so good as it is.
If these old houses, they're big enough so that you could hide a man in every corner.
You just gotta not let your imagination run away.
Are you going out there?
Well, of course.
Nobody there.
Now you just go and eat that sandwich I made for you.
Don't drink the coffee. If coffee keeps you awake, it won't.
Coffee never keeps you awake.
Thank you.
this morning. I heard your alarm. I knew you'd get up. Guess what I got.
I can't imagine.
Just what it takes to start the day off right. Let me get in my room. You don't save me having to go out and get dressed up. I had to get dressed to come over here anyway.
Oh, let's go by what I need.
Well, two cups of coffee, you pummel. Say, I guess you took her on last night about me coming to your door and all.
I'm not a very sociable person ordinarily. How can I resist an inducement like this?
What? Come on, I don't know all those big words. Just an ordinary guy works in a warehouse, that's all. Makes pretty good money, though. Hey, look, I got a couple of shots left over from last night. You want a little bit of yours?
No, thanks. It's not the recommended breakfast for your soldiers.
Oh, is that what you do? Hey, you mean they pay somebody to play the organ in church?
Some churches do.
Hey, if you don't mind about this, I just didn't know you were a church woman.
To me, a church is just a place of business.
Well, that's a funny way to look at it.
Why? People seem shocked because I took a job in a church. I regard it simply as a job. I'm a special organist, half way to do that, though.
Thinking like that, don't that give you a nightmare?
As a matter of fact, not for that reason, mind you, but I had the strangest feeling last night.
Yeah, I had kind of a lost night myself.
Funny. The world is so different in the daylight. But in the dark, your fantasies get so out of hand. But in the daylight, everything falls back into place again. Let's have no more nights.
Or let's make them more interesting. Hey, how'd you get to be a church organist?
I studied it in college.
I could have gone to college. Yeah, I used to play pretty good football, but they wanted me to take a lot of class, I think, you know?
Oh, they're that way.
Well, I'm just as smart as the next guy. Well, but I just didn't dig what they were teaching in school, you know? And the thing I hated most was principal product.
Principal product?
You know, you're like the principal product to Brazil, coffee, beans, snake oil, something like that. I was in school, I couldn't care less. Tell you what I cared about was girls.
Didn't they offer a course in that?
Would have done that, I would have graduated.
What's the matter? Can you still taste the coffee?
Come on, what do you think, I'm an alcoholic? Look, I just like to start the day off in a good mood, that's all.
You must be hilarious by noon.
Look, I'm just the kind of a guy employers want, you know, the happy worker. Come on, now make your morning happy.
This morning, you're exactly what I needed.
And it needs me in the evening, too. You don't know it yet.
I'll rinse off these cups.
No. Just spoil the flavor for tomorrow.
Well, thank you for the coffee. It's unsanitary, but delicious.
Well, should have put some of the germ killer inside. Well, I hate to leave early.
Think you can get through the door?
You know, you got the wrong impression of me.
Well, I meant because you have so many things to carry.
Oh. Like I said, I believe.
Well, it's been a pleasure, Mr. Linden, but I'm sure you have to get to work.
Well, don't you?
No, I'll have the whole day free for shopping.
The drape is just fine. Otherwise, it looks very nice. I'm sure it isn't very chic to take the second dress, but I like it.
We also look here to make it straight all the way around.
There, do you want to go back to your dressing room?
Thank you.
take it.
I didn't mean any harm. I just stopped to get a drink.
No. Oh, it was that man. That man. There was someone else there. That strange man was there.
Now, look, you've had a fright. Hysteria won't solve anything. Now, control yourself. Look, I'm Dr. Sanders. My office is right across the street. You've had a shock. If you would like my assistance, I'll be glad to offer it.
Thank you. Could I come with you now?
Certainly. I'll take her over to my office. We'll see that she's all right.
It was more than just not being able to hear anything. Make contact with anyone. It was as though for a time I didn't exist. As though I had no place in the world. No part of the life around me.
And then you saw this man.
Yes.
You looked at my back, but I wanted to get some of that written down.
I must have been talking for an hour.
Anything else? Anything you haven't told me?
That's all I mean. That's the whole story. He's been following me. That's all there is to it.
It isn't that simple, though, is it?
What do you mean?
He could hardly have been in the park this afternoon, or one of us men would have seen him. And that night in the hallway, you said yourself the landlady came up a minute later, and she didn't see him, did she?
What are you driving at?
It's been less than a week since you were in a car that crashed into the river. How you got out of that, no one seems to know. But that experience must have been a serious emotional shock.
You think I imagined all of it, don't you? You think I'm insane?
I didn't say that. I don't mean that.
I'm a competent person. If anything, I'm a realist. I'm not given to imagining anything.
Hogwash. All of us imagine things. Have you ever heard two men talking behind your back and imagined they were talking about you? Have you never imagined you saw someone you knew and walked up to them and found they were a perfect stranger?
I don't see what this has to do with it.
The point is this. Our imaginations play tricks on us. They often misinterpret what we see and hear. Do you agree?
I suppose so.
If that can happen in ordinary times, go a step further. Look what can happen in a high fever or following a serious emotional shock.
It doesn't seem possible that I could have imagined all of it.
Does this man, this figure, resemble anyone you've ever known? An acquaintance? Or your father?
No.
You have a boyfriend here or back home?
No, and I have no desire for one.
Never?
No. I'm surprised to find myself saying that. But it's true. I have no desire for the close company of other people.
Have you always felt this way?
I don't know.
Don't you want to join in the things that other people do? Share the experiences of other people?
I don't seem capable of being very close to people. I feel that perhaps I am trying to reach out for those other things.
Do you feel guilty wanting them?
I don't understand you.
I'm not a psychiatrist, and perhaps I'm being clumsy at all this. But I am suggesting that perhaps this figure represents a guilt feeling.
Oh, that's ridiculous.
Maybe. Frankly, I don't know.
Well, I know one thing. My imagination is playing tricks on me. I'm going to put a stop to it.
You're a very strong-willed person, aren't you?
I survived, that's what you mean.
That old pavilion out by the lake. Somehow you associate it with all this, don't you?
Go out there. I could put an end to that, too. I could go out
there. Now, don't be hasty.
If it is all my imagination, I could put a stop to it.
Maybe, but at least someone should be with you. Now, I can't possibly get away.
As you say, Doctor, I'm a person of strong will. And the time to go out there is now. And if I have to, I can go alone. I stopped for a bite to eat on the way in. Anyway, I have to practice at the church this week.
Look, talk about if I took you up afterwards, go someplace, dance or something.
I'm sorry. I'm not much for dancing.
You mind if I ask you a question?
I won't know until I hear it.
What, are you afraid of men?
No, I'm not afraid of men.
Well, you seem sort of cold. This morning when I brought you the coffee, friendly.
This morning I needed company.
Well, maybe you'll need company tonight. Better than working home alone.
Yes, it is. Should be finished around 9. Will that be all right?
It's okay by me. Say, see you in church.
Your lamp of soul, this organ, the music of this church, these things have meaning and significance to us. I assume they did to you. But without this awareness, I'm afraid you cannot use our organ. In conscience, I must ask you to resign.
That does not mean that I am abandoning you. Nor should you turn your back on the church. There is help here, and I urge you to accept it.
I've been waiting an awful long time for you.
My car's just over there. I know just the right place to go. You've been holding out on me. That's not the kind of pig you usually drag around.
You quit licking your chops. He's out of your class.
You want to bet?
Lay off, huh? I got something on the stove there, man.
Well, listen, I'll help you put it over.
I don't want her to think I even know creeps like you.
Good luck.
Miss Seven, you know?
Yeah. He's a college fella.
Tell me about this girl. Wanted me to meet her.
I said, how could I? You're my date, you know.
Said you didn't seem to enjoy my company, right?
That's not true. I really appreciate you taking me out with you. I've had a miserable night if you haven't.
Forget it. Come on, here. Join a party. Drink up. Look, I paid good money for that stuff. It ain't poison.
I'm sorry if I annoy you.
No, I don't get you. First you stand me off. Well, that's okay. That's class. Figure you got something, you're just holding back. Now, everything I say is okay. You're a mouse.
Yesterday, I didn't care. Tonight, I want to be with you.
Me or just with anybody?
With you.
You want to be alone, huh? I'll
leave
you alone.
No,
that's
no,
what
I,
you want.
I like being with you, really, I do. I don't want to be alone tonight. I want to be near you.
Far from the island.
such goings on. She wouldn't let me in her room this morning.
She's a strange one. She absolutely refuses my help. I can't say that I blame her. There's something about her that completely baffles me. I've urged her to call upon me if she feels she needs help, and I hope she will.
I can't let her stay in this house.
You won't have to worry about that. She's determined to leave the city again. She wants to get away as soon as possible.
I hope she does.
separation from other people. They're everywhere.
You're not going to let me go.
Locking my trying to prevent me from living. He's trying to take me back somewhere. I can't fight it now. I don't know what's real anymore. Thank you, doctor. But my last hope. If you don't help me, I have to go back there. Trying to take me back somewhere. Doctor, you've got to tell me what to do.